Good afternoon, everyone. We got a full house today. We're so glad you're here. This is Tamera. This is Patricia. And they have got some beautiful songs here. Let's get this party started.
That sounds great. We wanted to do a coffee house type event so that, you know, it's laid back music and just enjoying it. And I'm so grateful that you're here. This first song is called Wildflowers. Tom Petty was the author of that. You may remember some of his work. But I love this song because some people don't fit the mold. They don't fit, you know, and maybe you relate to that. And some of us need to be wildflowers. There needs to be beautiful flowers in the arrangement. And there's others that are just the wildflowers that grow everywhere and spread joy wherever they go. And so I think some of you might relate to that, may feel like one of those wildflowers. So I dedicate this to you today. Okay?
Carpenters. Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a
Different people have recorded it. I love it because sometimes I feel like the water is wide and it's hard to cross over. And what I found, it helps if you can cross it over with someone. And for me being single, I have found that I can call on the Lord, and I know we all can, but to get in the boat with me and go across. And so, but I love this for many reasons, and we need friends to walk with us too. Right? So I hope it speaks to you today. Oh, the water is wide, I can't cross over.
New, the grove grows
summer dew. She passed away probably about a year ago now, but it's called Let Me Be There. And just like Tamera, I'm single, and it feels like this is really talking about a man and a woman's love. But with me, I feel like it's really more about me and God. I hope you like it. Wherever you go, wherever you may wander in your life, surely you know I always want to be there, holding your hand and standing by to catch you when you fall, seeing you through.
In here that says, it won't be long before another day, we're going to have a good time, okay. And no one's going to take that time away. You can stay as long as you like. I love it when you have a friend where you can stay as long as you like. And you don't have to get somewhere else. So I love this song for that reason. Well, the sun is sure to see.
But I'm holding something in my hand. Can you see what it is?
Yes.
If you can't see it, it's a rose.
A rose?
A rose that I picked. Actually went off and cut it off a rose bush out of my yard a few minutes before coming here. So it's beautiful. It's a beautiful rose. It's fall time outside. It was only one rose on this whole bush. But when I picked it, guess what happened to me? There are thorns on this rose. So why? After the break, we're going to hear a song called Roses.
Roses.
And I want you to think about this. Why is something so beautiful also sometimes inflict pain?
Oh.
Why is that?
This song is called Roses, as Jim mentioned. Do you ever wonder what the Maker thought when he made us? And what he, when he created us? And it's called Roses because he made the rose. It has thorns. It's beautiful. Rose is beautiful. But then he wore that. It was on his head. They took his life. And maybe that's why God made roses. I don't know. But that's what the song is called. And I love the line in it that said, he must have known about the heartbreak long before us. He must have known about the mistakes, but still he chose us. When I think about that line, he knew about all my mistakes, and yet he chose me to be part of the kingdom. And I'm so grateful for that. His forgiveness and his goodness in my life.
Yes.
Must have known about the heartache long
whisper if you listen closely. Winter means that spring is just a breath away. So don't go any faster than this very moment. Sing a hallelujah in the pouring rain. Can't you see that you must have known about the heartbreak long before us? You must have known about the mistakes. Still, he chose us, planted the tree where he would die. Thorns down the vine, then he wore them. Love is a blood red stain. The beauty and the pain exposes. Maybe that's why God made roses. And just like petals fall into the ground, oh, we fall into the one who's resurrection.
I've had a lot of loss in my life. When I was a little girl, I was 10 years old, my mama passed away. And then my daddy was not a stable man. And I remember thinking when he would be out carousing and driving around drunk and stuff like that, I'd be wondering what's going to happen if something happens to him and I'm an orphan. And so that was a lot for a little girl to carry, because I assumed a lot of, you know, that weight of just the stress of all that. And then he passed away in my early 20s. And then I have a sister, my only sister, and she passed away some 23 years ago. And I still have a brother. This song talks about a brother, but my brother I still have. But the rest of them are all gone.
Oh, man.
And so this talks about meeting my family back at God's table in the end, you know, when we go to heaven. And it's just it's a really sweet song, and I'm glad Tamera got me to learn it, but it has been a hard thing to learn. It's been a little bit of difficult for me to get part of it down, and so please bear with me if it's not perfect, because it's brand new to me. But here we go. I am an orphan on God's highway. I'll share my troubles if you go my way. I have no mother, no father, no sister, no
pure and golden, but the ties of kinship, I had not known them. I know no mother, no father, no sister, no brother. I am an orphan girl. When he calls me, I will be able to meet my family at God's table. I'll meet my mother, my father, my sister, Savior, make me willing and walk beside me until I'm with him. Be my mother, my father, my sister, my brother.
And the first time I heard this, I was in Maine. In fact, I just recently returned from Maine, and I was hearing this song. I was sitting on the bluffs. If you've ever been up to Maine, you know that it's rocky cliffs over, and then you see the ocean. And I was sitting on those rocky cliffs, and I heard this song. And the first line is, who else would rocks cry out to worship? And, you know, God said, the rocks will cry out if you don't. And it's like, it's my privilege to sing to the Lord. And so I love this song, and I wanted to share. I thought we could share it with you, and I know that some of our members of our church, we sing this at church, so they'll be singing along too.
Who else would rock cry out to worship? Whose glory taught the stars to shine? Perhaps creation longs to have the words to sing, but this joy is mine. Thank you. Jesus, this song is forever yours. A thousand hallelujahs and a thousand more. Amen.
That was crazy. That was crazy.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Sometimes just soothes your soul.
Yes.
It just makes you just feel like, oh,
yeah.
It's going to be okay. God is with us. When I was thinking about the rose, and I was thinking about, I really did, when I pulled it out of my bag, I really did. I mean, it didn't bleed, but it hurt. And I was thinking about relationships I've had in my life. When I look around this room, I don't mean this as an insult, but I don't see any spring chickens around here. You know what that means? It means we've been, God's allowed us to live a number of years. And hopefully in a lifetime, we've learned a few things. We've learned, hopefully, some patience. We've learned how to forgive people. But we know that when there's a relationship, like Patricia talked about, when you're very, very, very close to someone, I don't care if it's a brother or a sister or a good friend or a parent or the child, whoever it is, there's beauty in that relationship. Is there not? But is there also hurt?
Sometimes.
Have you been hurt in relationships?
Mm-hmm.
I know I have. Yeah. But you know, it's part of God's plan. God gave us life. He gave us beauty. But he also has us go through pain. And sometimes we don't know the reason why, but we accept it as God's plan for our life, and he knows what's best. So today, or the next time you have an opportunity to go outside, you may have to put a jacket on because it's cool out there. If you're sitting in the sun and you feel the sun touch your face, it's chilly, but that sun on your face feels so good.
Right,
maybe you can think about that as just a kiss from God and a reminder that you're loved and that you're cherished.
Okay.
So let me just pray a prayer of blessing on you if I could. This is from the book of Numbers. It says, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you peace. Amen.
Let me be there in your mind.